talking with Dr. Holly Van Rimmen from the Oklahoma Medical Research Foundation. We're talking about age-related muscle loss. And before we get to just kind of your daily tips and tricks, what other kind of research is now going on at OMRF?
So in the Aging and Metabolism Program, where I'm the chair at OMRF, we have research going on in a number of different age-related diseases. So things like heart disease or arthritis. I mean, we have a number of different programs that are going on. But the research in my laboratory focuses mostly on skeletal muscle, and we have a new investigator, Dr. Benjamin Miller, who just joined us a couple months ago, who is also studying muscle. So in his lab, he's looking at how different ways that we can use to protect the proteins that are involved in skeletal muscle to keep the muscle healthy, and in particular the mitochondria. And in my lab, we've noticed that, what we see is the loss of muscle mass and weakness. The important thing is that the muscle doesn't work alone. So the muscle is very tied to the nerves that come from the spinal cord that that generate contraction to make the muscles move. And so this is a very tight relationship between these two tissues. And what we see is that during aging, this relationship actually deteriorates. So the neurons pull back from the muscle, leaving the muscle alone. And this is what contributes a lot to what we see as far as loss of muscle mass and weakness, because the neurons were providing some sort of a support system. And so we're trying to figure out what exactly is happening when the neurons disappear, and different ways that we can use to keep the muscle from degenerating at that point.
Really fascinating. And I'm sure you find that the whole body just works in tandem to make the whole body function as
it
should.
Right, right. So the brain is involved in this, and the muscle itself can release factors that contribute to the metabolism of the whole organism. So it's all very interrelated. It's really difficult, I think, to study any one tissue or organ, because there's so many different ways that they impact each other.
And back to the muscle loss, and you know, we were saying earlier, once you hit 30, things start to decline a little bit from there. You were saying more like your 50s or 60s. Mm-hmm. How can we combat this?
So I think the biggest problem is that we tend to be too inactive, right? So people just tend to sit way too much. So I think just getting out and being active, you know, as I said earlier, walking, you know, any kind of activity like yoga, stretching, whatever you can do, because I think that's the most important thing, is to keep everything moving. I think it's also important to watch your diet, especially as we get older. Tend to not eat as well, maybe. And so to make sure that you get enough protein in your diet is, I think, really, really important.
Okay.
But activity is the big thing, so just go walk the dog.
And back to the nutritional part of it, because I know everyone now is making these meal plans for the new year.
Right.
What exactly should a protein diet look like to aid in this issue?
Well, I think, you know, so I'm not really much of a nutritionist, but I think you just need to make sure that in your diet you're getting enough protein. So we know, you know, things like meat or beans, things like that. You know, just look at the labels and make sure that you're getting a balanced diet that includes most of these things.
And is that your biggest piece of advice for people of every age? Me, I'm in my late 20s, so
right.
I haven't quite hit that 30 mark yet. Is there something different that I should be doing as opposed to someone who's in their 40s, 50s, who's really feeling the onset of that problem?
No, I think it's still just staying active. I think that's the key throughout the whole process.
Okay. Well, doctor, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
We do appreciate it, and Happy New Year to
happy
you.
New Year.